So being a Sti is like a superpower. So
it's a superpower. Yeah, you drink something and then you become Sti.
Ich muss mich an dieser Stelle entschuldigen, dass mein Französisch komplett weg ist. J'ai oublié tout mon français, je suis très jolie, non.
Très beau.
Je suis très beau, oui. Désolé. Oui. Deswegen ist eine Dame da, die mir auch hilft. Und first question is, when I saw the movie, like the first 5 minutes, I was like, hä? Who are these people? Who is Vincent D? Who is Constance? Why a complete other story?
Pourquoi une autre histoire de Sti? C'est pas les gens
you didn't know it was another story.
I don't know. I thought it was like part two. Everyone's like, okay, I'm going to the part two, but it's not.
No, it's nothing not to do. No. That's what I said. Yeah, I mean, it's written everywhere, but I don't know. No, the thing is, I just wanted to tell a story about the Sti again, but about a Sti family. But not. I mean, I didn't want. Make like a sequel or a prequel or you know like a fucking quel. No, I don't care. No, but the thing is, I don't like that idea. You know, the first thing my producers told me in France after the huge success of Welcome to the Sticks, in Common Bendenchti, he said, you know, if you do like a sequel, we're gonna do. Minimum half of what we made, meaning more than I don't know 1 million, 100 million,
10 million,
something. Which is very bad.
On box office, ici.
Ah. Mm.
So I said no. I don't want to do. I mean, it's a very good reason not to do it.
Den hier kennen Sie bestimmt, Valentin Dwé, der Designer, den sich ganz Paris reißt.
Wer inspiriert Sie?
Sagen wir mal im Grunde wie uns selbst.
Und er hier, das ist, nun ja.
Muschi!
Das ist seine Familie.
Wie passt es mehr?
Hast du Schuh genommen?
Der Anzug ist eingegangen. Meine Arme sind ein bisschen länger geworden.
So being a Sti is like a superpower. So
it's a superpower. Yeah, you drink something and then you become Sti. you want to try? There you go. Here is the potion, the magic potion. Not now, but you're gonna become Sti.
Normally, it's not transparent. You wanna become Sti.
It's weird. Oh, how come?
French vodka.
Yeah.
How would you describe the relationship, la relation, du
in English?
Vincent, Vincent and
Valentin.
Valentin. Valentin,
it's okay.
There is no Vincent in the movie.
There's no Vincent at the beginning of the movie.
Oh, it's a kind of cool relation. I think they are together because they like their image, they like the couple image, and they are stuck in something like it, which is more in the how do you say the paraître. They look at themselves, so it's they are stuck a bit like in
show off.
Yeah, it's all about
a show off couple at the beginning.
And we can think it's they are gonna stay in that, but the story will show you the contrary.
How much
the opposite?
The opposite. How much Danny Boone is in Valentin?
How much? Oh, all of it. No, I'm not. I'm not that sure of in life. I hope so.
No, you're not.
Oh, thank you. I graduated in Belgium as a cartoonist, as a drawer. I mean, I designed
the chair.
Yeah, the chair. Yeah.
The chair is great.
Yeah,
I love the chair.
I designed it. Some of the chair
you
and
can,
the,
you can buy
the
it.
Furniture.
You really? Can buy it, yeah.
Yeah. And you can, yeah.
Is it like
it's
very, very...
because it doesn't work.
Yeah. Is it very expensive or is it very, very cheap?
Now it's cheap.
And it's dangerous.
We try to be... to sell it for more money, but
it's a perfect gift for La Belle-Mère. So, like, yeah, here,
exactly.
Take it.
Yeah, exactly. So... the Sti family also, the fact that, I mean, my connection with the character is that I used to be very poor. I grew up in a very poor family, poor neighborhood, and then I became famous and rich. So that's the connection of it. So sometimes, for example, you know, once for Welcome on Benden Sti, we screened the movie at the Élysée Palace mm-hmm. in Paris for the president Sarkozy, and I had all my entire family coming to the screening, and but my mother said no, I don't want to come because I have nothing to wear, no dress. I said okay, I'm gonna, you know, buy you a dress, and then I bought a dress for my mother, and then she came and she was a little bit stressed.
Nervous.
Because I'm very nervous because she was scared of making a mistake, you know, seated at the table during the dinner. So it was a buffet. So she was so relieved because it was a buffet. She said, oh, thank God it's a buffet.
Frau Ministerin, angenehm.
Bravo. Tata.
Maman.
Huh?
That's Maman.
You know, so it's very strange for her. For example, We screened the movie for the Macron couple at the Élysée Palace again, and I asked my mother to come. She said no.
But it would be a buffet.
No. Buffet. No, she said no. I have knee problem.
She said, what, yeah, but the thing is, it's the connection with the Valentin for you. It's how do you deal with your success and your
childhood.
Origin. Yes.
Yeah.
And it's the same for everybody who suddenly had a huge success. And how do you keep
deal
with all that? And your family and the how do they look at you after that? And
yeah,
qu'est-ce que c'est typique Sti and typique Parisien? What is typical Sti and what is very typical Parisian?
An expression?
Yeah. What do you think?
Language
and how the people like behave.
I would say, I would say like the Sti say a typical Sti person says hello all the time, okay?
Mm-hmm.
To people he doesn't know.
Mm-hmm.
In Paris, they never say hello. Never.
Okay.
They look at you. If you say hello, say, do I know you? Do we know each other? So why do you say hello?
It's just to be nice. They are scared. We are in Paris, people are scared to look at people. So we are looking in the eyes.
Yeah, because it goes very fast.
It's really speed, but it's also a question of not being connected with people, I think, sometimes.
Most of the Parisians, I mean, look sad actually when you take the subway. Mm-hmm. No, for example,
but
sad
and
tired.
Where do you have in Europe a place where you take the subway and everybody's like, yeah, it's so cool?
In
South
Rome.
America.
In Rome. How are you?
Yeah, it's not the same.
What I think is always is good in Paris. When you're in Paris, even if like me, you can't speak French, you just say, oh, bonjour. And they, okay, he didn't start saying like good morning and hello. So it's always good to say one, two words French and then like,
For example, tell me the truth. When you go to Paris and it's written in a like restaurant or a bistro or a, like English and German speaking, spoken. And then you go and then they don't speak at all. I mean, the waiter comes and says, qu'est-ce que tu veux? You say, I'll have English. No.
Anyway, it's also because French are orgueilleux, c'est self.
Very
happy.
They're stolz. Very.
How do you say in English?
Proud.
And sometimes they are ashamed to try something, to speak another language. They are ashamed to make mistakes.
I would say they're lazy. I mean,
I don't think so. No,
like
I don't
Italian.
Think so. I
Italian
think it's
always
a question
French people. I mean,
hola la honte. It's
no, man,
all question
school,
of that.
No, for example, the English you learn at school is not the same English you speak in England
don't
or outside.
Speak French, they don't, you don't really speak
yeah,
English,
because
so that's why.
I think it's because of the education.
Yeah.
Because of school. When I arrived in, I went to America, so I arrived there and I thought I was speaking English, and then, you know, I had a meeting with someone or a guy, the cable guy came to my place to, and I say, it was like, oh, wait, what a guy for her. I say, what the fuck is it? Is it, I, it was, you know, so we started to write all the things, and I thought, oh, I had to go back to school to learn
English.
Real proper English, yes. because at school it's not that that good. I mean, we're not, I mean, I don't know why.
Gibt's hier einen Toni?
Das bin ich.
Sie sind aus dem Norden, stimmt's?
Ich muss sitche, muss setche, geschetche, muss miss.
Sitchen, sitchen.
Also nicht so wichtig.
Und wisst ihr's, es regnet in Strömen, oh lala. Es pischt jo, oh lolo.
Klingt furchtbar. Es pischt jo, oh lolo.
What do you think, there are so many characters in the movie, but there's like one connection between your character and the mother. Why is a Sti mother so important?
Because my mother is very important, and Lynn Renaud plays my mother. I mean, even the dialogues in the movie are like very close to my mother's way to speak and to tell things, and emotionally also. You know, it was last week was my mother's birthday. She just turned 71, so I took her to the restaurant, and she was like the same as you know. She said, "No, just just a dish of something simple. I don't want a cake or anything." So yeah, of course it's your birthday. No, don't spend money. That's fine.
To you also.
We never know.
But it's women in the north are strong women, so that's why it's the role of Lynn Renaud is really important in the movie, and that's what you always.
And I have a recall about the Welcome to the Sticks when I was in the cinema with the German audience here, listening German audience laughing at the Welcome to the Sticks. I remember that they laughed a lot about the relationship between the mother and the son. It's kind of a very important thing also here, the relationship
it's
with the mother.
It's always the same. Yeah. The son and the mother is always a very strong connection.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Ich wünsche euch viel Spaß mit Die Stis in Paris. Amusez-vous.
Amusez-vous. Bien.
Avec Die Stis in Paris.
Amusez-vous avec Die Stis in Paris, yeah.
Thank you very much. Merci.
Ein Shampoo.
Das ist eine Sonnencreme.
Sowas benutzen die im Norden nicht.
Ah.